Hey everybody, welcome to Adrian's Corner. I am Adrian and this is definitely my corner. Okay, so today we're talking about Doom Eternal. Myself and Mr. K.
Hello.
Are going to talk about the good, the bad, and the ugly, and everything in between. Now, first and foremost, thank you for watching our video. It means a lot to have you guys here. If you're new and haven't subscribed yet, feel free to make that happen, as we'll be putting out weekly content from here on out. And if you like this video, throw in a like to make our day. So, here is what I liked about Doom. Let's start there. First, the backgrounds. Freaking gorgeous. The variety, the artwork, everything about it, 10 thumbs up.
I disagree with that.
You disagree with that?
So, I personally agree. Visuals, only on one aspect. There were certain areas that did not come across as, well, overall, good. There was bad areas, but for the most part, I agree. I would say it's a 9 out of 10, but I can't say it's a 10 out of 10.
So what you're really saying is you loved it, but you didn't quite love it.
Correct. There was an area in the game that it looked super cartoonish and it just drew me out of the game completely because I was like, what in the world is my looking at? I thought I was not playing Doom anymore. I thought I was playing some other random game. It was just weird.
Okay. Well, Mr. K, I know you gave it a 9 out of 10, which I think is still pretty good. To me, though, every zone felt unique and it served the game well. I know you disagree, but honestly, that was my opinion. Now the story. In my opinion, a huge step up from the garbage piece of shit one that we got in Doom, the Bethesda Heavy Metal, the reboot. I mean, in the previous game, gone was the dark and scary set design from previous Doom titles like Doom 3. Gone was an intense and intriguing storyline with excellent plot twists. No, instead you got brightly lit, cartoony, but crunchy and satisfying combat, I'll give it that. Frankly, in the previous game, the story felt like an afterthought to justify the type of gameplay Bethesda wanted to make. But this time around, the story, although it takes a while to get going, does provide a kind of cool backstory for the reboot Doom universe. And this, and no spoilers here, I think they succeeded in making that part of the game interesting.
To a degree. Not really, because as much as the story was interesting and intriguing, there just wasn't enough of the story to compensate for what was lacked in the previous Doom. There should have been far more interesting stories put into this game, but I feel like that was a secondary nature and not a first priority.
I get that there was not enough story. For me, considering the garbage that Doom, the reboot, the Bethesda Heavy Metal reboot, it was infinitely better, at least for me. That's all I'm gonna say. Okay. So let's move on over then to the gameplay, since I got myself talking about it. For me, now I'm a completionist. When I start a game, I love putting games at max difficulty, finding all the secrets, and making my character the strongest and most badass that is possible. I know, I'm a masochist, but that's what I love. And no matter how many games that we talk about here, rest assured, I will always play them on maximum difficulty. Now, there are other caveats to that, but that's another story for another time. So back to the gameplay. It's a giant slog. There's no two ways around it. I even tested after I beat the game and went back to a few of the later zones on easy, still a long and boring slog. Sure, the game pace is faster and honestly, for the most part, it was entertaining, but by game's end, I found myself having to forcibly sit down to finish this game so that we could talk about it here. Now, I know I said this was about what I liked right now, but it had to be said. And that's about as far as I can go for the nice side of this discussion.
Well, I do have a few more. So the guns. The guns were absolutely amazing in this game. They did a phenomenal job from the design, to the look, to the way they fired. I thought that they were a lot of fun. There was maybe one mod that I didn't care for, but overall, I enjoyed playing the guns. I wanted to mess around with them. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed the music thoroughly, unless you started dying. The music itself was great and matched the pace of the game. It got your blood boiling and made you want to just fight and keep going. But when you died, it just got repetitive. It felt like they didn't have enough tracks to move around, so if you died a lot, it couldn't change up at all. It was a positive, but it was also a negative in its own way.
You know what I think is negative about that? Honestly, the best part about the music was turning it off. That's right, folks. I played 75% of this game music-free because the music, as he said, repetitive. Well, guess what? It was boring. Only because, admittedly, I died a little bit early on and I realized, oh my god, heavy metal when you're dying, repeating the same part of the track over and over again, not fun.
There was one other thing about the guns that I did want to mention, and that is the fact that there was at times, because of the lights and the way they did the design of firing, you couldn't see what was in front of you if there was too many enemies firing and you were firing. It at times could blind you just based off of the amount of movement and the amount of the way the characters were moving in the game, because you're always having to move at a fast pace of speed jumping, speed walking, everything. It made it at times where it would get confusing to see where what person was what, especially the tighter the arena.
Yeah, but see, I think most of that, honestly, was you just closing your eyes and hoping for the best.
So I want to jump into the negatives real quick before you go hammer, because I know you disliked this game far more than I did.
Well, hold up. I didn't say I hated this game, folks. Not at all. And Mr. K, shame on you for thinking that I did. Because I am a lover, not a fighter.
Bullshit.
Okay, look, I know it's nitpicking, but my god, I don't want to be forced to sign up for a fucking account for a game I already bought through another platform to play your damn game. Okay, just had to get that out of the way. Continue, Mr. K.
So, one of my biggest and my largest negative in this game was the arena fights. At times, I felt I was being dragged into every fight had to be an arena. It didn't matter where you were, every location. It just didn't fit the game because of the way the areas were built. It just made no sense why there was just random walls, why there was random blockage. Like even in Doom, the first one, it kind of made more sense. You were going to select areas of certain heart damages and whatnot. But for this game, it just didn't fit the story, like at all. And I got frustrated because I was like, every fight felt like it was taking a millennia, especially the forced arena fights to get the upgrades, to get the certain items for certain gear. It was just aggravatingly annoying. And at times, I just felt like, nah, I don't want to do it at all. Because what's the point of being 100% if I have to struggle to have to keep doing arena after arena?
You know, it's almost like you didn't actually play the first Doom where everything was an arena play. Like, hello, let's just do arenas forever. Oh, and speaking of forced crap, remember the stupid tutorials early game that take you out of the action and force you to play the mini games to learn the concepts they were teaching? No effing way. Let me learn on my own. Oh, and did I mention the home base? Seriously, why on Mars' red dusty planet do I have to have a dull, crusty-looking gothic fortress that I have to keep going back to? That keeps breaking up the otherwise monotonous yet crunchy action of the game? Seriously, it was cool for 5 minutes. And after that, I found myself resenting having to wander around this giant floating trash can to do upgrade unlocks. So goddamn annoying. But at least the gameplay as a whole was solid, right? Right? It wasn't. Did the developers for Doom have a Mario fetish where they were watching some Nintendo-themed hentai one night and thought, hey, what if we incorporate Mario into Doom? That'll sure be sweet, and our audience will totally thank us. And ooh, what if we add tons and tons of jump platforming? Who cares about great gameplay? Let's just all go do Mario and shit on everyone. Get the fuck out of here with that garbage.
Well, I got one more thing. Regarding the Mario theme, yeah. It was like a goth that went heavy metal Mario. That wasn't sure if he wanted to be this badass dude. I feel like it's like the evolution of Mario that went from this little platform jumping game into this I'm a badass motherfucker bitch. And like this is like the futuristic of Mario from years and years of jumping on Bowser's head, and he's now become like this god killer because he was always killing demons in the beginning.
Oh, I got it. What if this is Bowser's fucked up nightmare from being jumped on repeatedly by Mario? Maybe this is Super Mario Brothers Doom Eternal. For Nintendo Wii, you. And look, final thoughts on this. To be fair, if you get this for free, or if it's discounted, then yeah, I'd recommend playing this for anyone who loves first-person shooters. Now, if you loved the first Doom reboot, It's still worth getting, but the $60 price tag, to be fair, might be leaving you feel like you overpaid. Just a fair warning.
I completely agree that it's not worth purchasing at the beginning at its current price. It's just there's not enough content, the game was too short, the overall slog, the certain areas of aspects of story just was non-existent. If you're looking for something that is just mindless, sure, this is a great game for that, but I personally would wait until it comes on a discount to buy.
Well, I agree, Mr. K. Honestly, I'm surprised that you and I agreed on this, because full disclosure here, Mr. K and I have strongly disagreed in the past about Doom. He loved the original Doom reboot, and I know a lot of you here might have as well. Personally, my biggest hang-up on it was I loved the previous Doom titles, and I kind of felt this new vision was a betrayal of what had been a scary and intriguing game. It has its moments, I'll give it that, and this new one definitely added some really cool backstory. I mean, aside from the Mario, you know, references, and there are a lot. Aside from that, honestly, it was okay. Just not worth your $60, folks. Thanks for watching us today. I appreciate each and every one of you, our subscribers, and those just coming in to check this out for the first time. It really means a lot to us. From Adrian's Corner, I'm Adrian. We'll see you next time.